Hi and welcome to this video. A few days ago I participated in the GMTK Game Jam where you have 48 hours to make a game. So in this video I will show you the game I came up with and how I made it. The jam started at 8 PM in the evening. The theme got announced and it was out of control. I instantly got some ideas which would match the theme. For example, you have to kill enemies that are coming towards you and they are slowly getting more and out of control. Or some kind of big mechanism or machine breaks and gets out of control and you have to fix it. Another idea I got was a platformer where you can control when you jump. I found this idea to be the most interesting one, so I brainstormed a bit and tried to expand this idea. I eventually settled on the idea that you can control your jump and are not able to stop moving. So you can only control in which direction you move. I didn't wait any longer and started developing at the same evening. I created a new Unity project and added a square. Then I coded the movement script for the square. The movement script turned out to be pretty easy to do. Even easier than a normal platform movement because I didn't need to check if the player is on ground to jump. And because we all know that gameplay and level design are the most important things in a game, I started by adding post-processing to make my square look nicer. After getting a bit sidetracked, I eventually got back to topic and added a bar on the player that fills up and indicates when the character jumps next. I then created a little red object which I simply named Death Wall. And as the name implies, you die when colliding with it. And that was everything I got done on day 1. I went to bed tired, but also inspired and motivated for the next day. On the morning of day 2, I opened up the Unity project and directly got to work. I created the tutorial level and 2 more levels. Level 1 is based around these death walls from earlier, and for level 2 I added these jump hits that boost you in one direction. I also updated the player design from one white square with that bar to 3 squares with the same bar. I created some effects like this jump or this death effect for the player. I think they both look quite satisfying with the post-processing effect and camera shake. One thing the game was still missing was sound. So I used SFXR, which is a free program for making simple sounds. And then I created a quick death screen that tells you how to restart, so the main gameplay loop is finished and you can actually play the game. I wanted to have a finished and playable game version on day 2. And I achieved that. On the final day, I focused on making more content for the game and adding some more details. For example, I made this particle falling effect in the background so it won't look as empty anymore. I then worked on level 3, which should be based around these movable boxes inspired by Portal. And it took like 2 or 3 hours making that level. I slowly ran out of ideas and couldn't quite come up with more interesting puzzles. But eventually I did manage to finish it and I still had a lot more time before the deadline. So I decided to upload the game on itch, make some screenshots and submit the game to the jam. I then relaxed a bit and tried not to worry about the jam too much. But after like 2 hours I came back to it and fixed some little bugs and balancing issues. I also found out that the game was quite challenging, so I made it a bit easier to not scare off new players. And after that day 3 was over and the jam ended. Now the rating phase started. I spent a lot of time playing and rating the submissions of other participants and it was a lot of fun. The very diverse game concepts and ideas people came up with were very interesting to see. I noticed that the platformer with automatic jumping concept was pretty common, but even then the games were still very different from one another. I was very excited to see the final results and the winners. So the results came in and it was just crazy. I have no idea how I got so high up in all categories. I'm definitely more than happy with this outcome. And I'm also very happy for the winners. This year's GMTK Game Jam was my first game jam I ever participated in, and it was a lot of fun. I learned some new things and got a lot of very helpful feedback. Have you guys ever participated in a game jam before? If so, how was your experience? Let me know in the comments. I'm definitely looking forward to the next game jam I will be participating in. By the way, I also have been very busy with my main game, so stay tuned for the next devlog. See you next time!